In this lecture, we will look at the text tool. I click on the text tool in the toolbar. Now I drag a frame on the canvas. I can adjust the size of the frame by dragging the sides and the corners. The text frame is the container or boundary for the text. This means the text cannot go outside the frame. This is the way how desktop publishing programs work. I will type GIMP. The default text color will be the foreground color. To change the text color, I go to the tool options and click on the colored thumbnail. I will change the text color to a gray by dragging value to about 60 and press enter. To continue typing, I click inside the text frame to select it again. Now I type a space and the word text. If I press the Alt key, I see the Move tool icon appearing. I can move the frame to another place by dragging inside the frame. To change the text size, in the tool options, I click in the text entry field behind size, so I get a blinking cursor. Now I will use the up and down arrow keys to adjust the text size. If I keep an arrow key pressed down longer, I will go faster. If I want to change the size of an individual letter, for example, I want to make the G bigger, I use the small menu above the text. I select the G by dragging over it. In the small menu, I click inside the text size entry field to get a blinking cursor. With my up and down arrow keys, I adjust the text size of the G. I click in the text box again to unselect the G. If I go to the tool options, I can see that changing the text size from here doesn't affect the G anymore. The G can now only be adjusted with the small menu. If I want the G to be a normal letter again, I select it and click on the Clear Style of Selected Text icon at the bottom left. Now I can adjust the G again inside the tool options. I will now insert some placeholder text. Open the .txt file that comes with this lecture. If I double-click on the file, it will open in Notepad. To copy the text, I press Ctrl A to select all the text, and then Ctrl C to copy the text. I go to GIMP and click inside the text frame. I delete the text that is in the text frame by pressing Ctrl A and pressing Backspace. Now I paste my copied text by pressing Ctrl V. As we can see, there is too much text for the frame. Let's make the text a bit smaller and set the size to 20. If I want the text frame to be less wide, I can drag the left or right side of the text frame in. At the bottom, I can see the dimensions of the text frame. I will set the width of the frame to about 400 pixels. In the tool options, I can align the text. At the right side of Justify, I can choose left, right, centered, and filled. Under Justify, we can indent the first line of a new paragraph. I click in the entry field and with my up arrow key, I increase the distance. Under it, we can adjust the line spacing. With my up and down arrow keys, I can increase or decrease the line spacing. Below line spacing is letter spacing. Here I can increase or decrease the space between letters. I will increase the space. To break up a word, At the end of a sentence, use a hyphen. To select a word, you can double-click on it. To select a paragraph, you triple-click. And to select all text in a frame, you press Ctrl-A. I click in the text to deselect. To choose a different font, in the tool options, I can click on the white font icon. I get a list where I can see my font. I can quickly scroll through the list by using the scroll bar. I can make the font previews larger or smaller by clicking on the magnifying glasses. I can search a font by name. To do this, I select the text under font. Let's say I want to use Arial. If I type the letter A, I see all fonts that start with an A. Again, I can scroll through them. If I type a second letter, the letter R, the list gets smaller and shows all fonts that start with AR. I will also type I and A, and the Arial font family remains. If you want to experiment with some different fonts, it's convenient to use the Fonts panel. I click on a font, and by pressing the up and down arrow keys, I can view the fonts. If you do not have the text tool selected, and you're not working on a text layer, double-clicking on a text layer will automatically select the text tool. Click inside the text frame and you can type. You can also kern text. Kerning is adjusting the space between two individual letters. This means you can place each letter where you want. Kerning is often done to make larger, important text, like the title of a book cover or the name of a logo, to look more professional or unique. I select the text inside the frame and delete it. I will make the text frame a bit larger. In the tool options, I set the letter spacing back to 0. I click inside the font size entry field and set the size to about 120. I click inside the text frame. I will use the text Perfect Match as the title. To improve the text, I think I want to reduce the distance between the P and the E. To do this, I place the cursor between the P and the E. In the small panel, at the bottom right, is the Change Kerning entry field. I click inside the entry field to get a blinking cursor. Now I use the up and down arrow keys to adjust the distance. I think -6 looks okay. Because letters that are adjusted with the small panel become unresponsive to the tool options panel and can't be resized anymore, it's best to save current text as a path. This has several advantages. First, you can now scale, rotate, skew, and place the text in perspective, all without losing any sharpness of the text, which is very powerful. And second, you can save the path, which means you can use the path in other documents. Let's have a look. First, I right-click on the text layer and choose Text to Path. In the Path panel, I now have a path of the current text. To save the path, I go to Configure this step, the Path menu, Export Path. You can save the path at any location. I will create a folder named Path, so I can keep my path all in one place. At the top, I give my path a name and I click on Save. When I open another file and want to work with my path, I go to the Path menu and choose Import Path. At the bottom right, click on Scalable SVG Image and choose All Files. I click on the path I saved and click on Open. I have now imported a path. Now I will scale my path to fit the area I want. I click on the Scale tool and in the tool options I make sure the path icon is selected. Then I click on the canvas. I scale the path by dragging a corner. I alt-click on the path thumbnail again to get a selection from it. I create a new layer and fill the selection. I press Ctrl D to deselect. New in GIMP 2.10 is vertical editable text. When you rotate a text layer, the text will be rasterized. This means you will lose the ability to edit the text. Now you can rotate text 90 degrees clockwise in two different ways. I will type the word hotel. To rotate the text, I right-click on the text frame and choose vertical left to right mixed orientation. This will rotate the text 90 degrees clockwise and the text is now editable. The second vertical option is vertical left to right upright orientation. Now each letter is shown horizontally, but the letters are placed on top of each other. The two options above do the same thing as the two options below, but they have the right side of the frame as the starting point of the text. In the next lecture, we will look at how to insert special characters or glyphs.